The Animus was created to relive the memories of our ancestors. Abstergo has released this as a prototype of one in use. My name is Charles Reeds. I am an assassin. Here I stand as Hester Pre awaits her fate upon the scaffold. I could not bear to see my friend this way. The only friend I have ever had. The only person, only woman, I have ever felt anything for. Months earlier, she was collecting materials out in the forest. I washed ashore in a small boat. She must have believed for a brief moment that I was her husband returning from the sea. Upon her discovery of me, two men approached her from behind. These two men knew what I was, and they threatened to hurt her if she did not leave me alone. As it turns out, these two men were closely related to my target. I saved this woman from these bandits, but before I could properly introduce myself, I blacked out. When I awoke, I retrieved my gear. And I met this woman named Hester Prin. She was kind to me. She saved my life, offered me aid, and in return, I offered her some advice. It was no longer safe for her here. These men knew her face. I told her she needed to leave before they found her, or me. In the days that followed, I became fast friends with her. We were walking through a small marketplace when I noticed a man. I figured it would be a good idea if we got our hands on some coins. With a few coins, we would be able to find her a place to stay. A place to be safe. I told her to use her charm to get a few coins off of this guy. Little did we know who it actually was. Turns out this man was Reverend Dimmesdale. Upon our discovery of who it was, Hester was immediately reluctant to ask him for any money. But he offered her a place to stay instead. She kindly accepted the offer and informed Dimmesdale that a friend of hers would be staying as well. "Of course," he said, and they were off. When I found where they were staying, I immediately noticed how fond they were of each other. In my hands. Initially, I believed that fate had thrown me to Hester. But it seems that she was meant for someone else. I was taught that nothing is true and everything is permitted. We work in the dark to serve the light. We are assassins. We work alone. And there she stood upon the scaffold, accused of adultery. I knew who it was, and I knew that it was my fault. My role in Hester's life has ended. My story with her has ended. But I fear a greater one has begun. To be found. The last pale light in the west. The last pale light in the west.
In this cold, barren place, still I see a faint reflection. So by it, got my way. Last pale light in the world.